Hi, my name is Graham Potter, and in the workshop today I've got some woodwork to do. The tree next to me is an olive. This is Olea oleaster, which is a wild form of olive with the tiny leaves. It's a very vigorous and strong tree, and this tree has been in its pot now for a year. It's early summertime, and so now is a good time to actually begin to start some work on this tree. To the untrained eye, material like this looks very promising. It's got some nice natural deadwood. It's already got some very well-defined live veins here, but we've got one or two problems. For a start, overall, the tree has got some reverse taper, and also there are one or two large chainsaw cuts, one here and another one here. So these large areas of flat wood are particularly unattractive, so they're something that we're going to have to deal with. But large fat olives like this are something that's quite common, and so what I'm hoping to do with the use of carving techniques is actually be able to make something a little bit more elegant and more interesting from this material. This part here is completely alive, so all of this bark here is feeding the foliage at the top. This has died back naturally, and as you can see, the live veins are very old and they've begun to roll in against the deadwood. So in carving this tree, we're not going to actually have to remove any live tissue at all. We will literally only be working on the dead wood. One of the least attractive parts of this tree is this young material here. This has obviously died back naturally where it's been cut, and you can see the chainsaw cut here. So in order to make that blend into the rest of the tree, and particularly this very old deadwood right next to it, we're going to have to be a little bit creative, and a lot of this will be removed. So ultimately we want to create some taper here and also some interest, rather than just leaving this big slug of smooth wood. Large olives like this are very often cut from much bigger trees, so they're very small parts of potentially very large trees which are naturally hollow. So you can see here we've got this massive chainsaw cut, and this probably would have been a live vein that went up into the rest of the tree. And also at the base here we've got this very large saw cut, and you can see here where the chainsaw's actually gone into the wood. And one of the problems of this is the wood goes actually underneath at this point, rather than what would be more aesthetically pleasing, the wood coming this way to build in a bar is. So that's going to be one of the things that we're going to be able to achieve with this carving work. The bulk of the wood here that we're going to be removing is going to come out very quickly. A lot of this is naturally hollow underneath, so this is going to come out very easily. And the tools I'm going to be using for the bulk of this wood removal are these terriers mounted in high-speed die grinders. And while they look very small, they have a very high cut rate, and so they'll remove this wood very quickly.